E aí, galera, tudo bem? Estamos de novo aqui no DCS World H64D, o produtor de vídeos, produtor sênior de vídeo do DCS, o Matt Egner, tá trabalhando que nem formiguinha, pessoal. O nosso amigo Matt Egner acabou de postar mais outro vídeo aqui do H64D. Eu dei uma prévia lá e o vídeo dele hoje é longo, tem 25 minutos. Então vou correr aqui, deixa eu ver aqui. Vamos lá no canal do DCS World. É, no fórum. Deixa eu ver aqui. H64D. Vai, migão, carrega. É, mini atualizações. 44 minutos atrás, página 2. É, vamos descer lá pro final, que é o último vídeo, que é o de hoje, né? Hoje é 16 do 3. É, pessoal, tá chegando a máquina. Deixa eu dar um zoom aqui, que eu não sei o tamanho da sua tela. Aqui ele deixou um vídeo com a descrição. Quer dizer, desculpe, pessoal. Aqui tem uma descrição do vídeo, como ele sempre faz, né? Como o vídeo é de 25 minutos, eu acho que ele vai explicar mais lá dentro do vídeo, né? Ele criou até uma espécie de um layout aqui para facilitar a vida de vocês. Espera aí, o que que é isso aqui? Ah, óbvio! Tem até um gráficozinho aqui. Beleza, copia aí, pessoal. Vai lá no site do DCS e copia esse aqui, ó. Mais uma ferramentinha para vocês trabalhar. Ou seja, além dos dois controles, dos dois pilotos, você vai ter de configurar um milhão de coisas. Vai ter de comprar no mínimo mais uns 10 controles. Nós tá é ferrado, filho. Tem neguinho que tá doido pra pegar isso aqui, mas quando vê que tem. Quando tem de ter 1 milhão de controles na mão, vocês estão é ferrado. Deixa eu correr lá, pessoal. Vou lá pro canal dele, que eu já deixei ele pré-carregado aqui. O vídeo dele tem 25 minutos. Matt Egno. Hoje vai ter legenda, pessoal. Deixa eu colocar a tela cheia aqui. Beleza? Matt Egner, lá vai!
Certainly some very capable AI command systems for fixed-wing aircraft, it would not translate well to helicopters. At early access release, George will be available for both the pilot and the co-pilot gunner, or CPG. You'll be able to fly an entire mission from the pilot or CPG seat. During the early access period, we'll continue to improve and refine it, particularly the automatic sighting and engagement abilities of the CPG. All right, so let's first take a look at George from the front seat. And as you might imagine, we're in the front seat. We're going to have George as the pilot in the back, and we'll be giving him flight directions. So because we're in early access, George is still a little bit of a work in progress, a couple things to clean up on some of his maneuver holding and a couple of the voiceovers. But for the most part, we're really far along in this. And I think you'll see that it's very easy to control. So, as we talked about in the controller's setup, we'll press our HOTAS, what we assign to hide show the George interface. When we do that, we can see it down here in the bottom left corner. And this may look familiar from Petrovich for the Mi-24. At the top, we have three boxes. The one on the left is our indicated airspeed in knots. The center is our current heading. And the left is our altitude in feet and radar. Below that, we have a compass rose with our aircraft symbol in the middle and our current heading at the very top, indicating by the inverted triangle here. The two larger yellow lines, those indicate the command heading that we're currently commanded George to fly. We have our home plate symbol here, which indicates our direct to. And here at the very bottom, we have our mode. So right now we're in HB, and that stands for hover bob up. We can change our modes by going to George command switch short to the left. So then we go to combat, One more time, we go to our CMOS, and one more time, back up to hover bob up. So actually, while we're here, let's go ahead and do the CMOS. So one time, CMOS, you can see the control here in the bottom right-hand corner. So to go from safe to armed, we'll go up on the George command switch.
CMOS is on.
If you want to go from auto to bypass, we'll go down.
Switching CMOS to bypass.
And as you may recall, the actual CMOS controls are on the back seat, so that's why we have a George command here to let him do it. So let's go back to our modes, back to hover bob up. And the first thing we're going to do is let's go ahead and establish ourselves in hover. And we can set our altitude in hover bob up by going up and down short on the controller. So I'm going to hit it, say, three times up to go up to 30 feet. It's going to do it in 10 feet increments.
Increasing altitude.
This way we're keeping with our in-ground effect. Go down by, say, clicking one click down, or go down to 20 feet.
Roger. Decreasing altitude.
So when you're in hover and bob up, a lot of what you're going to be doing is attacking from a hovering position, and you may often need to reposition yourself for the attack. And that's where we have the transition modes within hover bob up. So first, let's say we want to transition forward. We'll hold long forward on the switch.
Moving forward.
And it'll keep moving forward until we release the switch. So how about here?
Stop it.
Now, let's say we're behind a tall building and we want to slide to the right to peek around it. We'll simply push the controller long to the right and hold it there as long as we want to slide to the right.
Slide right.
And release. And conversely, let's say we want to slide to the left, we'll hold the switch long to the left.
Slide left.
And release.
Stop it.
And naturally, we can transition backwards. So often when you're in a hover, it's really easy to kind of creep forward, so this is a good way to move back when you need to. And release.
Stop it.
And the final element in a hover bob up is reorienting the aircraft to point where you want it to. So let's say I wanted to orient on this hardened aircraft bunker here. I would put my line of sight reticle on it and go George control switch short to the right.
Turn it direct.
And there it is. Okay, now that we're airborne, we can also change our mode to flight mode. And in flight mode, this basically corresponds to when you're in transition and cruise. So first, we can adjust our speed by short up and down on the George control. So let's say I wanted to go 40 knots. I'll click up.
Copy. Speeding up.
And if I want to slow down, I'll go down short on the control. to change my altitude, I will hold long up and down. So let's increase our altitude and I'll go up long. Leave it at 60.
Increasing altitude.
Okay, so let's get some forward airspeed. So I'm going to, let's say, go to 60 knots. So 70. Now, if I want to change my heading, there's a couple ways I can do it. First is kind of like a Petrovich. We can hold left or right long and move the heading indicator to where we want to fly on the compass rose. So let's say I want to go to 210. I'm going to hold right long and move the heading indicator to 21 and release. The same way, let's say I want to go to 120 at right off our left. Holding down left, release at 120. The other way is just again using our line of sight reticle, we can put it in the direction we want to fly and go right short. Okay, I'm going to start bringing my speed down by going short down.
Copy, just slow one down.
And let's go to a hover out here. Let's take a look at combat mode now. So I want to go to my TADS, making my TADS my sensor. So let's move the TADS to where we want to look. Let's say that building right there. We can align the TADS where we want to align our helicopter. And when in combat mode, go up short.
Roger, aligning.
So as you might imagine, this is super handy when you're heads down and designate a target for a Hellfire shot, and then bring in the helicopter so you have a good solid constraint box. Get some airspeed back on the helicopter. Back to combat. So we can do some evasive maneuvers as well. Like let's say we want to break 90 degrees to our right. We would hold the switch right long.
Right and right.
want to do the same thing to the left, we'll hold the switch long to the left.
Right and left.
In addition to left and right, we can also order him to do a 180 by going aft long. Okay, so those are the basics of using George as the pilot. Now we're going to jump to the back seat and have George as our CPG. So to demonstrate George as our CPG, I thought it'd be easiest to do a little mission. Zooming in on the right MPD, I've got my direct two set to waypoint one and my acquisition to waypoint two, where I have a bunch of targets. On the left MPD, I'm actually going to bring up the vid page, pads again, go to zoom, adjust my video brightness a bit. This way I can see exactly what George is going to be gauging through the TADS and also see the range to engage as well. So just like we did for the pilot, we're going to go ahead and press the key that we assigned to the George Hide Show Interface button. And we do that, we now have the interface down here in the bottom right corner with the currently selected weapon in the center, in this case gun. Cycle through the weapons, we'll go left short on the interface.
Pausing Hellfire. Pausing rockets. Gun lost. Hellfire's up.
Now you notice that the writing is in yellow, and that's because it's in essentially manual consent mode. So even after George finds, locates, and locks onto a target, you will have to give him a manual order to engage it. Kind of puts the reins on him. Whereas if you were to go up long and hold, it goes green, and that's essentially a free fire order that once he finds a target that's in range, he'll automatically engage it. But for now, I'm going to go back to manual control. You also notice that we have kind of a two concentric ring structure on this. The inner area, that's essentially equates to a short press, whereas outside the ring equates to a long press. So right now we have a low ball selected as the mode. If we were to go right short, it goes to low out. Once we're low out, we can set our trajectory. Right now it's in direct, but if we go to right long,
setting trajectory to low, setting to high, whistle set direct.
And now I'm going to go back to low ball. So later when we add the radar guided Hellfires, we'll be able to use left long to cycle between SAL and radar. And we'll talk about slaved, unslaved here in a second. Okay, with that out of the way, let's go ahead and pick up and head off to our direct tube. I've already transitioned to transition mode. It's your home plate symbol up ahead. That's our direct two. The segmented cross, that is our acquisition source, and that's going to be where our target's located. I'm going to go nose to tail trim because I'm going to be flying rather low here. And as you may have gathered, this is a part of the expansion of the Syria map. I'll leave the Euphrates and sprite over there. think you'll find once you have the aircraft nicely trimmed up, which is super easy to fly. Start slowing down a bit. And at 1.5 out. Okay, start to get myself set up here. And just keeping a close eye on my radar altimeter and airspeed. Okay, now to tell George where I want him to look for targets, I'm simply going to move my head to place the line of sight reticle where I want him to search, right there.
And slave it.
So he slaved over to look. Based on my helmet, you found two IFCs. We can scroll down by pressing down on the controller. Tracks, IFEs, let's go to IFE1. We're going to go right to select it. We stored it on system. He is targeting it. At this point, we're going to rise up, give launch consent.
Engaging.
Okay, one hit. Let's do another one.
Slave, deslaving.
Select.
Is stored.
And consent. Okay, let's take a look at co-op rockets. So I'm going to select rockets myself. I'm going to command him to go rockets. Select those trucks. And you can see we're actually in co-op mode. I'm going to go back, transition, and let's do a rocket pass. Also, we can go short right to adjust our quantity.
Rockets up 8.
We went from 4 to 8. And now I'm just going to get myself in alignment over here. As we talked about in the earlier video, I'm just going to line up the line of sight reticle with the I-beam, then we should be able to fire. Okay. Rockets away. rockets come off. And we're going to have George Wazup gun. And you can see if we go short right, we can adjust the burst length. Again, going to search here. Truck.
Target is stored.
And let's go ahead and give him free fire.
Roger. Good backs.
And come off. So folks, I hope you enjoyed this little look at using George as both your pilot and your CPG, and I will see you next time. Thanks.
Beleza, já vi que a coisa não vai ser fácil, seu Matt Egner deixou bem claro aqui para nós. Eu estava até já traduzindo aqui os controles só do piloto. Aí o cara vem e me joga mais um monte de controle. Nossa senhora. É, pessoal, soltar os primeiros vídeos do H64 vai demorar um pouquinho, filho. Vai demorar um pouquinho. É muito controle para você configurar e é muita coisa para você lembrar. Nossa senhora. H64D, pessoal, mais um vídeo. Agora vamos ter um piloto lá na frente, AI. É, filho, quem não pode pilotar com um artilheiro humano vai ter de pilotar com os AI, né? E pela quantidade de comando que ele passou aqui, nossa senhora. Mas a primeira coisa que você tem de aprender quando chegar essa máquina é configurar os controles de voo. Depois que você configurar os controles de voo, você começa a configurar as outras coisas, né? É isso aí, pessoal. Não esqueça de compartilhar o vídeo. Não esqueça de dar o joinha no vídeo aí. Pera aí, deixa eu dar meu joinha no vídeo aqui. Ó, tem que fazer assim, ó. Vem cá e dá o joinha no vídeo do cara. É isso que eu quero que vocês façam no meu aí. DCS World AH64D. Mais um vídeo do Matt Egner, né, pessoal? A previsão de lançamento é até o dia 31 desse mês. Mas pela velocidade que eles estão colocando o vídeo aqui, deve sair um pouquinho antes. Só não sei quando. E para quem não sabe, o DCS vai ter de fazer uma atualização grande aí antes de lançar essa máquina aqui, viu? Então quando vocês souberem que tem alguma atualização chegando aí, ou a data ou hora, pode saber que a máquina vai vir junto ou vai vir logo depois. Falou, pessoal. Valeu. Até mais.